Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats. Stop right now. It's Melanie C. He's got specs appeal. It's Romesh Ranganathan. And their team captain, Sean Locke. And facing them tonight, fresh meat, it's Charlotte Ritchie. His eyes are smiling, it's David O'Doherty. And their team captain, John Richardson. Now welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys and statistics. Did you know, for example, 3.5 million Londoners use the Underground every day? My gran's been using the Underground every day for years. We buried her in 1994. 43% of men over 36 say they don't have any close male friends. So, mission accomplished, eh, ladies? And 33% of Brits have mistakenly called or texted the wrong person. I accidentally called my mum the other day while having sex. It was so embarrassing. I said, I'm sorry, mum, I'll call back. I didn't realise you were having sex. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. It's our panellist job to guess the British public's top three most popular talking points. Sean Steen, what have the nation been talking about this week?
Cheryl Cole was accused of miming on X Factor, wasn't she?
Yeah.
It's a big scandal.
I don't think she was, though, because she put out a very strongly worded statement in which she said...
Melanie, do you think she was miming or not?
Well, if she's miming, she's miming really well. And if she's singing, she's singing really well. And I think she's probably better at one than the other.
Ooh.
Hey, we've all seen her sing live. Didn't the Queen's golden doodah?
Well, no, there was another. I've seen her sing.
The Queen's golden doodah.
Did you not know the Queen has a golden doodah? She was on Embarrassing Bodies. They did a royal special. So Cheryl's denied that she was miming.
It's really difficult.
Is that not
because...
part of the job though? I mean, you were in the Spice Girls for years, and you have to sometimes on a TV show mime, right?
Yeah, I mean, often you mime because you don't have the choice because they're not set up for the sound. But it's the X Factor, and there's lots of contestants singing live who've had no experience on live television. Which, when you've been in a band like Girls Aloud, you have.
Right.
But even if you are a really experienced singer, it's hard to do a good job. And they're going, I wonder whether it's like, sorry, it's a fly. I've not got an issue there. Well, I've got a few, but not that one.
There wasn't. She mimed that. There wasn't a fly. She mimed that. I also seeing it from Cheryl's point of view. You know, everyone's going, oh, she mimed, she shouldn't have mimed. Well, what you got to remember is, of course she mimed. She's trying to sell a record. If she sang that record live, that'd be a PR disaster.
I think if she was miming, it's just the worst thing ever. The idea that she can't sing live on a show that's all about live singing. I know, I'm stating the obvious.
You're a singer as well, right?
Yeah, yes.
Did you used to be in bands?
Yeah, I did. I was in a manufactured band, actually. It was an all-girl...
Spice Girls weren't manufactured!
I didn't mean to look at you! It was because of... You're in my eye line! and I was in it, and it was a kind of classical all-girl group, and we sang.
Would you ever be tempted to go on X Factor?
Oh, no, because I get cross-watching it because I think it's like a talent show, but I think it's also mainly an entertainment show.
It's so cannibalistic, isn't it, that basically, Cheryl Cole sings on the... It's like this sort of monster that eats its own shit. Like, and it'll come get to the point where the backstory will be, yes, well, I won X Factor once, and things didn't really turn out for me, so I'm ending up back on X Factor. I think it's just a big... It's a big scam. One day, there'll be it'll be exposed, it'll be like PPI. You know, everyone will get all their money back from the phone calls.
You'll get a phone call, did you ever buy a One Direction single?
Yeah,
I did. Well, you could be owed money.
Yeah.
Are you a big X Factor fan, Melanie?
This is a tricky one for me because, of course, Mel B's a judge on it.
Right.
So I have to. I have to.
Lie.
I do support her. I have to lie. No, I do support her, and she's the best thing on it because she says it like it is, but I fucking hate the show. And I'm totally bored of it, and I can't believe it's still on the telly.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if you've ever sat on a fence before, but that's not how that's done.
It's just so contrived.
Yeah, it's not like, not like in the old days of the Spice Girls. It's not like they didn't have an idea for
it. It was completely organic, the Spice Girls.
Of course it was, yeah.
But the X Factor is so done, isn't it? Who's gone on to have a great career from the X Factor?
One Direction.
Well, that's it. How many years has it been on? 11th, we're in the 11th year.
I mean, I've done pretty well since I won it. Granted, it was a different show then. I'd be like, at the end, I'd be like, fax me, vote for me by fax. And I'd be the fax mime.
Oh, do they still do that on it as well? Call. Don't you hate that?
I hate contestants. That. If the song is dog shit, you are not going to convince me by doing that. Do you know what I mean? Like, I hated everything you... Oh, you want me to phone? Yeah, I will do.
No, you say that. I don't like the song on the Gay Exchange advert, but I call.
What was that number again?
0878 That's one I know you from.
Okay, John, who do you think is going to win?
The Italian one, because that's what they said on Gogglebox. And that's where so I get all of my X Factor knowledge from. They said the Italian one who likes dogs is going to win it.
I can't believe he's not going to win it, Dad. Such a fucking idiot.
He said it.
One of them on the X Factor said he seduced a lady who may also have been on the X Factor, but he said he got to sixth base. I think that's where you take a shit while she's brushing your teeth. I think that's it. You're so comfortable.
Is that the really incredible, talented Stevie dude? Didn't he go out for dinner with Sam and Cal to a fucking harvester or something?
It's actually called harvester, not fucking harvester, but I made the same mistake.
Sorry,
I had no idea.
How many fuckings are allowed?
Oh, you're allowed loads of them, don't panic.
No C words, though.
No C words?
Back to the C word at some point.
Okay, lovely, no problem.
Thanks.
She's going to play the C word at some point. what do you think of Simon Cal? People criticise Stevie Ritchie for being cheesy this week. This is how he responded. That's pretty distressing. I think his belly button's winking at me.
Why did he have, like, sport socks and sweatbands on?
Because he's like, sort of the new Sporty Spice.
Is he? Is he Sporty Spice?
He's the new Sporty Spice. Look at him.
Shit.
It's a waste of good cheese, that. I like the laugh, so I have the triangle one. But there's no need for the blue cheese there to get involved. His cock clearly isn't there.
I think he might have gone emmental. Yeah. I've got another one.
Sounds of cheese, Joe. Yeah. Stay tuned.
Yeah.
Sean Locke, everyone.
Shame it wasn't Parmesan or some other hard cheese. Hard.
His publicist said, damn, that was a bad idea.
These jokes could be better.
Yeah. Let's see if X Factor's up there. Yeah, Cheryl's been accused of miming on The X Factor. The X Factor ratings have embarrassed Simon Cowell. He's really lost face and then replaced that face with a much bigger, wonkier face. OK, Johnson, what else have the nation been talking about this week?
Is it the complete breaking down of any physical boundaries? What have you been talking about, touchy McPenis hands?
Everyone's talking about Taylor Swift
Oh, yeah, okay.
Selling shitloads of albums.
So she's taken her music off Spotify. That's the big news, isn't it?
She has, yes. I don't understand how the world. She's made $250 million from music, and I've genuinely never heard one of her songs.
Well, you are in for a treat. Have a look.
She points out there that the haters got to hate, and can I just say on behalf of the haters, we are out there 24/7, 365 to try and stop shit like that happening.
I feel like I'm probably her target demographic, actually, and so I wanted to be like, don't like it, really don't like it, and it came and I was like, the chicken. Has anyone seen Chicken Run? When the chicken, the really big one, she doesn't notice, but her feet are tapping. And she gets really cross about it. I felt like that. Like, when I heard the song, I couldn't help it. And I think it's so good. I think it's so good.
I don't know whether that analogy's made it any clearer for you.
The one good thing about Taylor Swift is, I've done in my research of her, is she hasn't really made a career on dancing around in her pants, has she? Which a lot of people seem to do these days, don't they?
Was she doing that video?
She wasn't really in her pants, was it?
Granny pants.
Yeah, which was ballet gear, but you know, a lot of people basically, let's be honest, are performing in lingerie, yeah, in sort of soft porn stars, yeah. Old fashioned, the sort of porn I used to enjoy. Before I found God. Looking at me. But they do, you know, Beyonce, she's like the biggest star, biggest earning star female music star, yeah. Or male music star in the world, I don't know. Or not male. She basically spends a lot of her time in underwear, you know, singing in her underwear. Why can't you get a singer, just come on, lovely voice, in a fleece?
Okay, so Taylor Swift, back to her. Romesh, are you a fan?
Massive fan, yeah. I sort of understand where she's coming from in terms of like wanting to take her music off Spotify, because if you're getting it for free, why would you bother paying for it? It's not a business model, is it?
On Spotify, artists are paid around 0.006 cents every time one of their records is played. That seems reasonable, doesn't it?
Look at poor Taylor Swift, she's struggling.
I know, she hasn't... Yeah, because she wasn't making any money. I was out with her last week, and, you know, it's her around, and she gets this old tonic, just tonic and a glass, and then she has this sneaky bottle from the club and just tops it all up.
100% sure that's Taylor Swift you're out with.
Oh, no. It was my mate Barry who runs Swift Taylors.
Or a dry cleaning service.
Yeah. Good to know. Let's have a look and see if Taylor Swift is up there. Yes, Taylor Swift has had her entire back catalogue removed. I apologise. I know what's coming, and I don't think you'll like it, but I like it. Genuinely don't know if I can do this. Yes, Taylor Swift has had her entire back catalogue removed from Spotify. We'll do it in sections. My granddad had to have his entire back catalogue removed. Something to do with his prostate. Well, that's it for part one. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 out of 10 Cats. We're still trying to guess the most talked about things over the last week. OK, fingers on buzzers. What do you think?
Is it the,
Keep
not
going.
The face. Well, there's been a revolution has started this week, Jimmy.
So this was... Explain what happened. What was the story?
Well, I believe it was an ice bonfire night, and then some people went out and wore masks and chanted at McDonald's, and the whole world collapsed. It's a bit shitty, I think, organising a sort of anti-capitalist march on a night when people are already setting fire to things. You're sort of stealing the glory of bonfire night there. If you start a riot on, like, a Wednesday and stuff gets set on fire, you can go, God, we started that. But everyone was already setting fire to things.
It was a Wednesday, though.
Was it?
Yeah. Oh, right.
I stayed in.
Of course you stayed in. There was fun going on outside.
Nobody actually knows what it is they're doing. They've just gone to kick off for a bit. So, like, when you watch an interview, they'd go, what are you doing it for? Just, you know, the leaders and that. They don't know what's going on and that. Like, let's sort it out. And the thing is, it's so easy to take pot shots. But running stuff is actually difficult. So, when before I became a teacher, I was all for, like, teaching properly. And then when I started doing it, I just turned to page 65 and get on with it, you pricks. Do you know what I mean?
There's one person who didn't wear a mask, isn't there? Russell Brand. And I think the funny thing is that he's the only one not wearing a mask, because obviously if he wore a mask, people wouldn't know he was there, would they? I mean, so it's a big publicity for his book.
What's it called?
Revolution.
In fact, if his book's called Revolution, he shouldn't be out there trying to sell it. He should be trying to encourage people to steal it.
Shouldn't he? Yeah.
You know, all it's ended up, he's backpedalled so much now. He started out saying, don't vote, it's stupid, pointless to vote, don't vote. But he's now come out, Russell Brand, and said, no, what I'm saying is, actually, he goes, who am I supposed to vote for? So if you reduce that to what he's actually saying, it's what everybody says at every bus stop or news agency, you go, politicians, good, what are they like, eh? How that lot get in? Oh, no, no, bloody hell.
In his defence, right, we all bitch and moan about the government because they are shit and they have been for years and it's getting worse. How are we ever going to change it unless we come together and all stop moaning at bus stops?
The main problem is now is people get the politicians they deserve because they don't take any interest in politics. Mm-hmm. And him saying stuff to people who are disaffected already and aren't engaged with the political process, don't vote, is the most moronic, self-serving, pathetic bit of attention-seeking wank that has ever spewed on the Tiger's moron's fucking mouth in history.
I think people are being mean to him just because he doesn't have a posh accent. I would cut him some slack. It's the thing we have at the moment's rubbish, and it needs people to sleep out under temporary tarpaulins, maybe, to change it. I don't know.
You're suggesting going camping.
Yes.
Probably the reason I hate him so much is because I'm a dad, and I've got this fear that one day my daughters will bring something like that home. And he'll come in and go, oh, such pleasure to be in your charming abode. Mother-in-law is very delicious.
Well, the protest in Trafalgar Square is not one of the most talked about things over the last week, but Russell Brand joined thousands of angry people protesting against capitalism. It was a great night for Russell. He managed to ship 5,000 copies of his new book. Right, fingers on buzzers, one more thing still to get.
Well, I don't know. Probably by the time this show goes out, even Mrs. Baker won't be talking about it. But is it the news that Norman Baker's resigned? Hold the front page. He resigned from the Home Office.
This was the Lib Dem politician, Norman Baker, he's resigned because of the drug policy, right?
Yeah, well, he resigned because he said, in a very, very sort of bad metaphor, he said it's like walking through mud working under Theresa May, which is not that difficult, is it, walking through mud? I think he meant treacle. Yeah. He said it was very, very difficult to work alongside her, so he resigned in what I would describe as a very petulant, childish way, like, I'm resigning, when he doesn't realise his purpose there is not to get along with them, it's actually to annoy, be a nuisance, you know, just make things difficult for her. You know, he should have just, like, you know, hung around, I don't know, given her a nickname.
Theresa May, what would you have suggested?
Yeah, well, diesel ass, I think that'd be a good one. Just spreads that around. As a shit in a drawer or something like that.
I can't imagine you ever doing that in a workplace, Sean, but presumably at some point you were employed somewhere and, you know, with a proper job. Mm. Did you ever make a nuisance of yourself?
Well, not deliberately. I don't think... I've been sacked quite a lot.
In your defence, you needed a shit and there was a drawer there.
Yeah. No, I've never been in a high-profile enough position to have a drawer.
Well, the politician that resigned, Norman Baker, actually is in a band called the Reform Club. Have a look.
See that tram sitting there all alone, blowing Hey Jude through a traffic cone, on a crowded pavement. People rushing everywhere, they're passing by and they don't care. Piccadilly Circus, Piccadilly Circus, don't complain. Piccadilly Circus, it's cold again.
he transforms just from an ordinary guy to a rock star by putting a hat on.
That's a good song, though, isn't it?
That one that we just heard? No, it is not.
If you're a Liberal Democrat called Norman, working in the Home Office is the coolest thing you're ever going to do. And it feels like when I leave a house party and nobody's really listening and nobody cares.
So, well, I'm pretty going then.
All right. Get out of the way of the fridge, I've got four cans in there. Yeah.
So, there's also been calls this week for Ed Miliband to resign. What would you make of that, John?
Well, I would like to stand up for the man, but the fact is he is depressingly shit. I imagine every decision he makes, he shits himself about. Like, if I open the door myself, will people think that I can't get someone to open the door for me? But then if a woman opens it, do I look sexist? Or if a man opens it, will people think I'm having an affair with a man?
Carr, what do you make of Ed Miliband?
He's kind of... I think you make the point that he's basically worried about how he looks so much more, and there is a sense that if somebody's, like, desperately wanting to appear a certain way, then maybe they don't actually stand for anything particular.
And this week he tried to give... some money to a beggar. Well, he was walking past a beggar, and then some journalists see him walk past. So here's a picture of him giving some money to a beggar. Best will in the world, that's not how you do that.
Are you supposed to even give money to beggars?
I buy them booze because I worry they're going to spend it on food.
No, but it's difficult because...
I fuck them, because I've usually run out of change.
You do. I just think, look, I can't walk past and give you nothing, so I'll give you a good seeing to.
It is a big social issue and something I battle with every day because homeless charities insist you should not give beggars money because you're not helping them.
Okay, but those are people that used to be in a band with you.
Hey, everyone's doing all right, mate. The one who's on this friggin' show.
Well, let's have a look and see if Norman Baker is up there. At the end of that round, Sean, Romesh and Melanie have 2 points, John, Charlotte and David have one. Our next round is pick of the polls. John, Charlotte, David, pick a question. What would you like the look of?
The screaming man with his hands over his ears.
OK. Most people hate the sound of their own voice, true or false?
What? I do hate your voice. But it's a really good test if you get a new sound system or TV at home. If you just leave you talk for 10 minutes, if it's still working, then it's not bad.
Like 10 minutes to get a word in edgeways on this. I agree, that is annoying, isn't it? What if I go really close to you? Hi, David.
Yeah.
See, I'm this close, but I'm still not touching you. It can be done.
Do you find your voice sort of annoying or...?
It is annoying. I used to do a thing where if I thought of something while I was out, I would phone myself and leave it as a message on my answer machine. And I could never do it, cos as soon as my answer machine picked up, I went, fuck it.
The thing I don't understand about you, though, is you do have kind of quite a nasal voice, but then you're brilliant at doing accents. Why don't you just pick an accent that's better and just do that?
I would, Jimmy, but they tend to label that more of a mental breakdown than I.
Well, you do a very good Spanish. Quite a sexy Spanish, I think. Just do Spanish from here on in.
The fact that you find it sexy is why I stopped doing it, Jimmy.
Do the Spanish.
Eh. What do you want, my friend? No, that's...
That's more Mexican. I just think we should find a different voice for you and we should just stick with it.
I agree. Liverpool, I would stick with. That's a
Can you do Scouse?
Everyone can do Scouse, can't they? It's the one
I don't think
does.
It's the accent that's a problem, is it? It's more the pitch.
This is such a fun round for me, really. Is there a possible round on small dicks we could do next as well? Don't feel I'm taking enough of a hammer in here.
That's what your girlfriend said.
Charlotte's got a nice voice. You've got a very... You say things properly.
It's so hard to talk after someone said you have a nice voice. Sometimes I lower it to sound, like, more mature and, like, I know what I'm talking about.
So do I. Is that... I couldn't believe what my How real voice sounds like.
I mean, you've got quite a posh voice, haven't you?
Yes. There's no way around it. And I used to get teased if I ever tried to make it not posh, because everybody hates that. So every time I tried to temper it, my friends just would not allow it. It was...
And your friends were... your friends weren't Destiny's Child.
They were.
I think you just got to have faith in your own voice and just...
This is good now. This is the new one.
It sounds like Morgan Freeman with more energy.
Morgan Freeman's more... I'll never forget the first time I saw Andy Dufresne. My voice is very, very scratchy, but it sounds quite nice, and that's why I talk quite slowly when I talk.
Just do that voice forever.
Okay.
I can do one impersonation in the world, and it's one word, and it's John Motson, the great football commentator, saying the nickname of my favourite football team, Tottenham Hotspur, and he says, Spurge. The worst is when people try to do an impersonation of this. People particularly from this country.
You're talking about the hairstyle.
It always ends up offensive. After it'd be like, is that right? Sure, look at you with your bombing a potato.
You realise this show is edited and that's the only thing we're going to use it. Melanie, do you find your speaking voice, do you like it?
It depends, and I find it changes a lot as well. I think, like everybody, you kind of adjust the way you speak for who you're speaking to. Because I'm not going to speak to, like, Sean, I'm not going to go, you know, like, there, Sean, how's it going, mate?
Right, wow.
I don't know, it's just weird. If I'm on telly, I'm not going to talk really fast and really Scouse. No. But if I'm pissed, you might understand me.
You're saying the Scouse people maybe isn't accent, they're just drunk. Good point. Sean, do you like your voice?
Well, the problem with me is not my voice, it's usually what I've said.
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest, no, it's not just the voice. Do you ever get the feeling like you'd just like to have a little holiday from yourself?
Oh, gosh, a little break. Yeah.
Just like a couple of days off.
Would you be somebody else in the meantime?
Oh, that's complicated, isn't it? Possibly, either way. Just a couple of days off.
But not the full operation, you just want to dress up and...
Yeah.
Scientifically, don't you hear your voice inside your head is a register lower than when what it actually sounds like?
You hear your voice lower?
You in your head...
Oh, I'm so sorry.
When I first heard my voice back, I just cried for ages because it was so horrible. And the worst thing about it is that your voice, when you know, like when you're in a photo and you've got a little bit of a belly and people say, oh, no, that's not how everyone sees you. Your voice, you're the only person that hears it the way you like it. So when you hear the recorded version, that's how everybody hears it. It's like you only seeing a six-pack on yourself and everyone else thinks you're a fat bastard. That's basically what it's like.
But also, nobody is as critical of your voice as you are.
I don't think that's been the case.
Well, obviously, there's freaks, but...
OK, well, let's get some answers on this. So, most people hate the sound of their own voice, true or false? What are you going to go with, John?
Shit, yeah.
You're going to say true?
Yeah.
OK, what are you going to go with, Sean?
Well, I like fun. I'm going to go false.
OK, I can tell you the answer is... Well, it's very close, but it's false. Only 47% of people hate the sound of their own voice. People really shouldn't judge others by their accents, but they do, though, don't they, though? That's it for part two. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 Out of 10 Cats, and the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your question. Best way to seduce someone?
Tether a goat.
What, sorry?
Tether a goat to their fence outside the house. Just leave a goat there.
And then...
Well, you leave it there and then they bring it in. And then you a couple of days later, you go, oh, did you find my goat? And they go, oh, yeah, it's in the garden. And you sit down, you start chatting about the goat, you know, and they've become attached to the goat. And then you sort of say, well, you know, it's amazing, you know, we've got so much in common. Before you know it.
Wow.
just lean across and say, it's a lovely go, isn't it? And you just go.
Who's that to? Who are you doing that to?
To the person you've given
the
go
person.
To. That's their shoulder, that's their shoulder.
Oh.
What's the matter with you people?
I think that might be actual sixth base.
I've always wanted to ask Mel this question. Has any guy, any sleazy guy ever gone, I know what you want, what you really, really want? Do you know what I mean? Like, in a disgusting, horrible way?
You know, not so much in that way, but it's probably the thing that is said to me the most.
Speaking of Wannabe, Wannabe was voted the catchiest song of all time ever last week.
Scientifically proven.
Scientifically proved to be the catchiest song in the world.
It won the Ebola Award for Music.
Historically, like, being in a band is a great way to get laid, isn't it?
Oh, I imagine, yeah.
But
when you've got songs like Two Become One, ho-ho, it's on.
Yeah. But I kind of messed it up by wearing tracksuits all the time.
Do you have groupies?
The thing is with the Spice Girls, our fans were mostly very young girls or gay guys.
Apparently, insulting girls is meant to be. I've heard, is it called
Shut up, will you?
Meant to give girl like a sort of underhand, like mean comment, and then her confidence is lowered, and then you can pounce or whatever. And someone
pounce.
Actually, well,
I mean, if you're going to pounce, don't bother dressing it up.
Ah.
The whole idea behind negging is like if there's a really attractive girl, they believe that they're above you, self-esteem wise. So you have to do little. Like digs, but you have to do it like in a disguised way. Like you go like, oh, that's a nice dress. Doesn't go with those shoes though, does it? Or whatever. And then, but the thing is, you get your drink as the night goes on, and you just think it's going anywhere. It's kind of go, you're a fucking twat, aren't you?
Similar to Sean's goat trick, I genuinely wooed my first girlfriend when I was 17. I had a enterprise where I would come to your house and fix your bike if you're bike wasn't working, and she phoned me up, brackets, at my parents' house, and I came, and I've mostly fixed her bike, but didn't fix all of it, so then I had to come back and fix the rest. And she had an accident in the meantime. We went out for 2 months.
I've been seduced. Well, someone's attempted to seduce me. It was a distinguished elder gentleman. I was a young lad hitchhiking. And,
Are you writing erotic fiction on the show now?
He was chatting away and he said to me, he sort of starts to suggest the idea that I might be interested in another aspect of sexuality. And I was sort of going, no, not really, mate, no. And he said to me, surely we should try all the fruits in the garden, surely. And I said, fuck off, right? But what I wish I'd said was, it's not the fruit I'm worried about, mate, it's the gardener. I didn't think of that till the next day.
Yeah, of course, by that time, you were trussed up in the back of a truck. John, have you ever chatted anyone up? Have you ever used a line?
No. 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 I play the long game. I can cook, I'll clean, I'll beg.
All right.
This is all direct lines I've used in clubs.
If you were trying to seduce Charlotte, let's say, how would you...
I have a girlfriend, Jimmy, and I will not risk that relationship for the sake of one of your little jokes.
So, are you worried that Charlotte may fall in love with you if you... I think you're going to be all right, mate.
All right, then, well, all I will say, Jimmy, is on your head be it. If my life collapses as a result of this...
You're insured against this, don't
you?
Panic.
To be there to pick up the pieces.
OK, Charlotte, prepare to be seduced.
Here we go.
Oh, it's happening now. OK.
Heard that before as well. What brings you to this Wetherspoons?
I'm here for a quiet drink with my boyfriend.
That's me. That's me. I'm on either side of you now.
Threesome?
Okay, best way to seduce someone, what do you think?
I think it's probably listening, isn't it? Taking an interest.
It's a way to keep someone's attention.
Money, showing
presents.
Them all your money.
Scream.
Okay, look at all the money I've got. Look how much money I've got. Look, I've got more. Look. Bring all the money in.
Giving them present. Loads of presents. Lots of presents.
It's not presents.
Oh, eye contact. Scooter. Get a little scooter. And just follow it. I like you.
What was that? Follow them in a scooter.
Scooter, just those little kid scooters. So you're not threatening. Like a car, if you follow them in a car, that'd be threatening, creeped out. If you know those little scooters that kids are. I like you, I like you. I'm slowing down for you now, so we're right in the same place. I like you.
Romesh, what did you think?
Eye contact.
That is the right answer. Yes, the best way to seduce someone is to make eye contact. I have to say, it didn't work for me. All she said was, what are you doing? Stop touching my eye. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are John, Charlotte and David have 1 point, Sean, Romesh and Melanie have 4 points. They're tonight's winners. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
All new Drifters over on E4 this Thursday at 9. But if you want it now, get yourself onto 4OD. Coming up next, well, due to the skullduggery of one nasty Ray purchase, toast is in it, big time.